Well, hello YouTube, it's your girl Jeanne coming at you with another video, and as you can tell by the title, okay, this is gonna be a long video, huh? Well, hello YouTube, it's your girl Jeanne coming at you with another video, and as you can tell by the title, this video is going to be about the 5 fragrances that I would wear on New Year's Eve if I were going out. So if you guys are interested in seeing the 5 fragrances that I would choose to wear on New Year's Eve, then go ahead and just keep on watching. Alright y'all, so first things first, stop what you're doing. And leave me your scent of the day down below. I would love to know what you guys are wearing today or tonight whenever you're watching this video. Also, if you are new to my channel, hello again. My name is Jeanne. This is my baby girl, Zori. Welcome. And if you are returning, thank you so much for clicking back onto another video. I truly, truly appreciate you guys' support. So if you have not already, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below and give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more videos from moi. So this video is going to be in collaboration with my baby girl. She is here because her daycare is closed for the week due to some of her teachers being diagnosed with COVID, so they had to quarantine everyone. So that's why she's here, and I posted on my community tab to see if you guys would mind, and a lot of you guys said bring her in. So this is Zori. Say hi.
Hi.
Say how are you?
Hi. <laughs> And
she's just gonna be keeping us company. So I'm not gonna go into depth on these fragrances because baby girl is running the show today and she gets very antsy very quickly, so I don't want her to be too distracting. So I'm gonna go ahead and hop into the list because I have 5 fragrances and I've talked about all of these before besides one. I have 3 more luxurious fragrances and 2 designer fragrances. I think one fragrance might be discontinued and the other designer fragrance is a little pricey, so I apologize for that. But when we are celebrating the new year, we typically pull out our expensive fragrances, our special occasion fragrances, and I think that these fragrances are definitely that. They definitely fit the bill for that. I also feel like these fragrances will work very well for like black tie events as well. So Christmas parties, things like that, you don't necessarily have to go out and buy it now. You can wear them for the upcoming year. So that's something else that I have for you guys. So this is for New Year's Eve, a black tie event, something like that. These fragrances will definitely fit the bill, especially if they're like in the fall and winter. So the first fragrance that I'm gonna talk to you guys about very briefly, because I've spoken about this fragrance countless times on my channel, because this is one of my favorite fragrances ever in my collection, period. And this is also my scent of the day, which is Deline Exclusive from the house of Parfums de Marly. So this fragrance to me is a very sweet, fruity, rose, powdery, vanillic scent. It also has a smoky touch along with some woodiness, and I absolutely love this fragrance. This has rose, lychee. This also has some oud and some incense and some vanilla. This is absolutely incredible. I love this scent so much. It's so powerful. It's so elegant, sophisticated, but also sexy at the same time. Some people say that the powderiness in this fragrance is a little too much, but for me, it's a very creamy, vanillic experience. It's absolutely stunning on my skin, and this scent lasts all day and all night. This is a powerhouse of a fragrance, but this is still feminine and sexy at the same time. And this is my scent of the day, and this is one that I highly recommend to wear on New Year's Eve or for a black tie event. So hopping into the next fragrance, this scent is one that I haven't spoken about a lot on my channel, but I really enjoy this fragrance. I have kind of neglected it over the last year, but I'm definitely gonna pull it out more in these colder days. And this is Decadence from Marc Jacobs. And this fragrance is one, I don't know if it's discontinued or not, but this is a very, very nice scent, especially if you like deep, sexy, rich, unique fragrances. This is that. So this fragrance to me is a woody, powdery, iris fragrance. It also has a little bit of fruitiness to it. It has some sweetness to it, but it's not too much. That's what I like about this fragrance. You get notes of iris, you have some woody notes in this scent, you also have some vanilla and some plum. It also has a little bit of a green touch to it as well, which I find this to be very unique. I used to have Aura from Mugler, and Aura for me was a little bit too much. It kind of smelled like root beer because it had like this green root beer type of scent to it that I did not like, but this fragrance to me fits me a lot better. So if you are interested in a more nighttime fragrance that's more unique, that has like a green touch to it, but it's still a little sweet, still a little juicy, I think you will really enjoy this fragrance. But this is extremely unique, so if you do not like to veer out into like the green realm, please do not try this fragrance because you won't like it. I do not want you guys to come and tell me that I told y'all to buy this and you don't like it. So this is beautiful. I love the bottle, even though sometimes it can get a little obnoxious with storing. This is a very nice fragrance if you want to smell unique, if you want to smell powerful, if you want to smell like a bad girl. This to me smells like a bad girl because this is not your everyday girl next door, happy, pretty, feminine scent. This is very sexy and sensual. And I think that this will be perfect for New Year's Eve or a black tie event. So this is Decadence from Marc Jacobs. So this next fragrance is one that I've spoken about so much on my channel. It's actually getting a little bit ridiculous, but I really, really love this. And this fits for a lot of occasions. And this is Tobacco Rose from the house of BDK. This fragrance is absolutely incredible. This is a beautiful, sweet, woody tobacco rose fragrance. It has some sweetness. It has some fruitiness. It has some spice. It's warm. I really enjoy wearing this fragrance a lot. So you get a ton of notes in this fragrance. Like I said, I've spoken about this a lot on my channel. Of course, this has rose, this has tobacco, this has some vanilla, this also has some cinnamon in it, and this also has some chocolate. So you get a lot of gourmand touches in this fragrance while also getting some balsamic touches as well. I really enjoy wearing this fragrance, especially if I want to be bold and sexy and sensual, but also kind of sweet at the same time. I find this fragrance to be extremely gender fluid, and this is definitely one that I feel like people should wear for New Year's Eve or for a black tie event because this is definitely a special one. Alright y'all, baby girl wanted to get down and she's watching her tablet, so if y'all hear stuff in the background, it's her tablet, so don't worry. But we have one more after this fragrance and I'm so happy that we're like kind of getting through this video. So this next fragrance is one that I actually fell in love with last year. I have had this for a while and I haven't spoken about it because I wanted to see when I should talk about it, what occasions this will be fitting for. But this fragrance is extremely comforting to me, but I noticed that this has a special touch to it which I find will be great for a black tie events and for New Year's Eve or something like that. And this is Santal Blush from Tom Ford. And this is the old packaging. It comes in like the traditional like darker bottle now. And I'm so happy that I have this bottle because this is so beautiful to me. It's so stunning. So of course this fragrance, hence the name Santal, this is a sandalwood heavy fragrance. And this scent to me is just a very warm, creamy, spicy, slightly aromatic type of sandalwood. I absolutely love this fragrance. This has a note of fenugreek and it's very prominent in this fragrance, and once you smell it, you'll smell it right away. But the sandalwood pushes through so beautifully, and the sandalwood is so creamy and just a delicious sandalwood without being too like wood chippings. I don't like when sandalwood is like a dry wood chipping type of sandalwood. I like it to be a little bit more creamy, and this is more of a creamy sandalwood. I really, really enjoy this fragrance. This to me screams elegance, sophistication, and this also has some sweetness to it from the benzoin that's in the base, and this also has like a musky quality to it as well, which I find to work well for all genders. So I think that this fragrance is extremely gender fluid as well. I really enjoy wearing this fragrance to bed because like I said, it's very comforting and cozy to me. But at the end of the day, I do think that this has such a beautiful unique quality with that fenugreek. So yeah, this is a beautiful scent. I think it will work so well for New Year's Eve and for black tie events. And I see a lot of people that are like posh really enjoy this fragrance as their like signature scent. So if you want to smell like money, I think Santal Blush is the way to go. And last but certainly not least, we have my last two scents of the day. They're actually a combo, but you could definitely wear these individually because they're stupid expensive. If you buy both of these for like a combo, they're stupid expensive on their own, but like buying them together is kind of ridiculous. And I have Baccarat Rouge 540 the Extrait de Parfum, and I have Oud Satin Mood from the house of Maison Francis Kurkdjian. Now I'm gonna go ahead and warn you guys, my daughter recently scratched up the label, so that's what I get. It's my fault, I left it out. So the label on my Extrait de Parfum is scratched, which is so annoying, but it is what it is. Like, I can't even be mad, it's my fault. But these two together are so elegant, so posh, so bougie. I mean, these two on their own are those adjectives as well, but when you place these together, it is extremely beautiful. You could do a combo similar to this if you have like Chagoff Oud and let's say Cloud or Cloud Intense or something. You can get the same vibe, but it's not the same. This combo to me is extremely sexy, it's alluring. I find this combo to be extremely gender fluid, so I think that all gender will love this combination, especially if you like jammy rose oud combinations and like a musky, ambergris, salty, slightly sweet jasmine woody fragrance. These two together are just incredible. I absolutely love both of these on their own, but these together kind of takes the fragrance to a whole nother level. Granted, this combo is extremely expensive, but if you own one or the other, you can definitely find other fragrances to like add that vibe to it. So if you have like Baccarat Rouge 540, the original, or this one, you can take Chagoff Oud from Swiss Arabian. You can take Oud Bouquet from Lancome. Something like a Jammy Rose Oud combination with your Baccarat Rouge 540 or your Cloud Intense or something. You can get kind of a similar vibe. But these two together are absolutely stunning, and I find that these will be amazing for like a New Year's Eve party or even a black tie event. These on their own will be great for that as well, but I find that when you layer these two together, it just takes the fragrances to a whole nother level. So yeah, this is Baccarat Rouge 540, the Extrait de Parfum, and this is Oud Satin Mood from the house of MFK or Maison Francis Kurkdjian. Well, that's all I have for you guys today. I hope y'all enjoyed today's video and our special guest, Zori, my baby girl. She is literally just doing her own thing right now, but in the beginning, she wanted to be all on mommy. Go figure. But again, I hope you all enjoyed today's video and you guys didn't mind our guest. So if you are new to my channel, I do quiz you guys at the end of all of my videos just to see who's been rocking with me into the end or whatnot. And for today's video, I want you guys to leave me the baby emoji for my baby girl because she was in today's video. So leave me the baby emoji so that I know you guys made it until the end. And baby girl surprisingly did a great job. So kudos to her. Give her a round of applause. But if you'd like, please leave me down below what you're thinking about wearing for New Year's Eve because I would love to know. And yeah, I will see you guys in the new year. So happy new year. I love you all so, so much.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Yeah.